Lab-engineered bacteria take in solar energy to output clean electricity. To seek out a more sustainable source of solar energy, scientists from the Swiss Federal Institute of Technology in Lausanne are starting small. The researchers designed bacteria to produce solar electricity, which they hope to scale up for widespread production. The team inserted tiny fluorescent tubes made of carbon atoms into bacteria and observed how the tubes were distributed as the bacteria divided. The two types of cyanobacteria they studied, Cynetocystis and Nostoc, get their energy through photosynthesis, like plants do. Adding in nanomaterials like carbon tubes can help the bacteria produce significantly more electricity when illuminated by light, according to a new study published in Nature Nanotechnology. Now, the EPFL lab is working on using the engineered bacteria to create a living photovoltaic that mimics the materials found on solar panels. Now, the chemical engineers at the EPFL are looking to lower the cost and environmental impact of putting nanotubes into bacteria. They noted that unlike today's solar energy technologies, the bacteria have a negative carbon footprint. After all, they absorb carbon dioxide through photosynthesis. In the future, researchers hope to program bacterial DNA to allow it to produce energy autonomously with no nanoparticles required. What's great about bacteria is that you don't need a factory to build each individual bacterial cell, because these bacteria are self-replicating. They automatically take up CO2 to produce more of themselves, which is a material scientist's dream. Another interesting aspect is that when nanotubes are inside the bacteria shows a significant enhancement in electricity production when it is illuminated by light. These living photovoltaics are biological energy-producing devices that use photosynthetic microorganisms. The researchers envision a living photovoltaic device based on cyanobacteria that have automated control over electricity production and does not rely on the addition of foreign particles. In terms of implementation, the bottleneck now is the cost and environmental effects of putting nanotubes inside of cyanobacteria on a large scale. With an eye towards large-scale implementation, the research team is looking towards synthetic biology for answers. The lab is now working towards bioengineering cyanobacteria that can produce electricity without the need for nanoparticle additives. Advancements in synthetic biology allow them to reprogram these cells to behave in totally artificial ways. This allows them to be engineered so that producing electricity is literally in their DNA. Researchers create new semiconductor to boost solar cell efficiency. The team at the University of Michigan in Ann Arbor have created a new kind of semiconductor that is layered atop a mirror-like structure. This structure can mimic the way leaves move energy from the sun over relatively long distances before using it to fuel chemical reactions. This approach could one day improve the efficiency of solar cells. Energy transport is one of the crucial steps for solar energy harvesting and conversion in solar cells. Researchers have created a structure that can support hybrid light-matter mixture states, enabling efficient and exceptionally long-range energy transport. One of the ways that solar cells lose energy is in leakage currents generated in the absence of light. This occurs in the part of the solar cell that takes negatively charged electrons and the positively charged poles, generated by the absorption of light, and separates them at a junction between different semiconductors to create an electrical current. In a conventional solar cell, the junction area is as large as the area that collects light, so that the electrons and holes don't have to go far to reach it. But the drawback is the energy loss from those leakage currents. Nature minimizes these losses during photosynthesis with large light-gathering antenna complexes in chloroplasts and the much smaller reaction centers, where the electrons and holes are separated for use in sugar production. However, these electron-hole pairs, known as excitons, are very difficult to transport over long distances in semiconductors. The researchers explained that photosynthetic complexes can manage it thanks to their highly ordered structures, but human-made materials are typically too imperfect. The new device gets around this problem by not converting photons fully to excitons. Instead, they maintain their light-like qualities. The photon-electron hole mixture is known as a polariton. In polariton form, its light-like properties allow the energy to quickly cross relatively large distances of 0.1 millimeters, which is even further than the distances that excitons travel inside leaves. The team created in the Lurie Nanofabrication Facility the polaritons by layering the thin, light-absorbing semiconductor atop a photonic structure that resembles a mirror and then illuminating it. That part of the device acts like the antenna complex in chloroplasts, gathering light energy over a large area. With the help of the mirror-like structure, the semiconductor funneled the polaritons to a detector, which converted them to electric current. The advantage of this arrangement is that it has the potential to greatly enhance the power generation efficiency of conventional solar cells, where the light gathering and charge separating regions coexist over the same area. While the team knows that the transport of energy is happening in their system, they aren't totally sure that the energy is continuously moving in the form of a polariton. It could be that the photon sort of surfs over a series of excitons on the way to the detector. They leave this fundamental detail to future work, as well as the question of how to build efficient light-gathering devices that harness the photosynthesis-like energy transfer. The study was funded by the Army Research Office and Universal Display Corporation, and Universal Display Corporation has licensed the technology and filed a patent application. Breakthrough discovery in carbon capture conversion for ethylene production. A team of researchers at University of Illinois Chicago has discovered a way to convert 100% of carbon dioxide captured from industrial exhaust into ethylene, a key building block for plastic products. Their findings are published in Cell Reports Physical Science. While researchers have been exploring the possibility of converting carbon dioxide to ethylene for more than a decade, the UIC team's approach is the first to achieve nearly 100% utilization of carbon dioxide to produce hydrocarbons. Their system uses electrolysis to transform captured carbon dioxide gas into high-purity ethylene, with other carbon-based fuels and oxygen as byproducts. The process can convert up to 6 metric tons of carbon dioxide into 1 metric ton of ethylene, recycling almost all carbon dioxide captured. Because the system runs on electricity, the use of renewable energy can make the process carbon negative. In UIC's approach, an electric current is passed through a cell, half of which is filled with captured carbon dioxide, the other half with a water-based solution. An electrified catalyst draws charged hydrogen atoms from the water molecules into the other half of the unit, separated by a membrane, where they combine with charged carbon atoms from the carbon dioxide molecules to form ethylene. Among manufactured chemicals worldwide, ethylene ranks third for carbon emissions after ammonia and cement. Ethylene is used not only to create plastic products for the packaging, agricultural, and automotive industries, but also to produce chemicals used in antifreeze, medical sterilizers, and vinyl siding for houses. Ethylene is usually made in a process called steam cracking that requires enormous amounts of heat. Cracking generates about 1.5 metric tons of carbon emissions per ton of ethylene created. On average, manufacturers produce around 160 million tons of ethylene each year, which results in more than 260 million tons of carbon dioxide emissions worldwide. In addition to ethylene, the UIC scientists were able to produce other carbon-rich products useful to industry with their electrolysis approach. They also achieved a very high solar energy conversion efficiency, converting 10% of energy from the solar panels directly to carbon product output. This is well above the state-of-the-art standard of 2%. For all the ethylene they produced, the solar energy conversion efficiency was around 4%, approximately the same rate as photosynthesis.